My name is Gerard Batten. I'm a member of the European Parliament for London for the UK Independence Party. And we're here today outside the Grove Hotel where they're having the Bilderberg meeting because I'm one of those many people from many different political points of view who are asking the question, what are these people meeting for? I think this year is very significant because it's the first year in 59 years that we've actually got members of the mainstream press and media turning up to actually interview people like me and Alex Jones, who's here and filming me today, and asking what's going on. That's a major breakthrough. And I think that the reason that people are very upset about this is because they don't know what the conclusions are of these meetings. Now, they say they don't have any conclusions, but are we really supposed to believe that 130, 140 people of the most powerful, richest, influential people in the world give up their time, fly across the world to come here, and it doesn't have a significance? I don't believe that for a minute. If it isn't significant, why would they come? If it is significant, what does it all mean? And I think the reason that a party like mine, the UK Independence Party, is soaring ahead in the polls and getting votes is because people now feel that politics is something that's done to them and not something that's done for them. And this is the heart of the malaise. People feel that it doesn't matter what they think, it doesn't matter what they believe, they're going to have these policies that they don't want thrust down their throat anyway. Oh, the Queen of the Netherlands is here.
And her son is about to be king.
Yep, and she comes to every one of these
meetings. Okay, so specifically, though, talk about the 60s and that vote and the CIA funding the euro.
Well, 1975 is the last time that we had a referendum in this country, and it wasn't about joining the EU because Ted Heath had already taken us in with no mandate, no democratic mandate to do it.
But under a trade deal, just like in the US, we're under free trade.
That's what they told us, but everybody who knew anything about it knew that wasn't the case anyway. But anyway, we got in, Harold Wilson won an election saying, I'll give you a referendum on the EU, and it was about whether we should accept his renegotiated terms, stay in or get out. And we don't know the exact figures, but the CIA put money into the Yes campaign, the BBC had meetings every day to make sure that there was a Yes vote delivered, major organs of the press were involved in that. So the No vote were totally outspent and outclassed in terms of a campaign.
So is this not a corporate takeover via EU government?
Well, that was the CIA, so presumably they get their money from the government. So I see this as an instrument of American foreign policy at the time, because as Henry Kissinger said, who do I talk to when I want to ring Europe? He doesn't want to ring 20-odd individual nation states and have to worry about dealing with them. He wants to deal with one centralized authority, a United States of Europe.
Sure, it's Bilderberg that gives the orders in the U.S., though. It's the main contingent is Americans and Brits and then some EU. We've gotten their minutes. We've gotten their documents. They say what you just said. Carl Quigley, who was allowed into their minutes in the 60s, wrote Tragedy and Hope, and he said, autocratic thing run by central bankers, end of freedom, controlling both major parties and countries, Democrat, Republican, Labor, Tory, creating the illusion of choice. Is UKIP going to call for criminal investigations of this?
Well, I think what we'll do, when I get back to my office, I'm going to be looking at the rules in detail and writing to David Cameron and raising the issues that I think are relevant. So we'll do our best. But I've written many letters, Alex. A lot of them get ignored and don't often actually result in much action.
But big things have small beginnings.
Yeah.
If you could speak for 1 minute to the Bilderberg attendees, the royalty, the people, the corporate barons, the government regulators, the EU bureaucrats that are arriving with people that they regulate, if you could say 1 minute of words to them, as a member of the European Union Parliament, what would you say to them?
I would say, if you are really here to talk about things in the public interest, which is what they maintain, why do you think you can achieve it in secrecy? Why wouldn't you achieve more by being public? Okay, you could have a discussion about what the problems are and the solutions in private, but any decisions that you arrive at, any policy recommendations should be in public, because you need to take the public with you. And obviously they're not doing that because the public wouldn't want to go on the trip that they've got planned for them. But I'd ask them to do that. If it's genuine, be open and honest about it. Because what people feel now is that, as I said earlier, politics is not something that's done for them, it's done to them.